Where's the doctor in charge?
Doctor?
Dr. Aziz. Doctor, where is he?
Doctor, yes, we said that I take you. Doctor.
Why you don't know?
Lungehindebetændelse er en mindre følgeinfektion, som kun opstår, når en større sygdom nedbryder immunforsvaret. Hvad var den egentlige dødsårsag?
Det var det eneste, hun fejlede.
Det er umuligt.
Il est entré à l'hôpital, il n'était atteint que d'une pneumocystis pneumonia, pas de maladie majeure. Ensuite, il a développé un champignon dans la bouche, ses plaques sur les bras, cette mycose sur toutes les jambes. Maintenant, son cerveau se décompose, il pourrit de toxoplasmose, bon sang, une maladie de chat.
Two months before its nominating convention, the Democratic Party began preliminary work on its 1980 platform.
Fellow members of the platform committee, I am Bill Kraus, liaison between Congressman Philip Burton and the gay community of San Francisco. The gay rights plank I'm asking to be included does not ask for special privileges. It does not ask anyone to like us. It does not even ask that the Democratic Party give us many of the legal protections which are considered the right of all other Americans. What this amendment asks is that the Democratic Party recognize that we, the gay people of this country, are also human.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Hi, Phil.
Hi.
Thank you. Thanks very much. Thank you.
We'll be back.
You know, doctor?
No.
Here we are. This is...
When is his T-cell
killed? I gotta tell you, Dr. Gottlieb, this is weird, man.
Look,
he doesn't have any.
How can he not have any T-cells?
Well, his immune system's gone.
It's way past his bedtime. But let me...
Morning. Good morning, Dr. Guinan.
Yeah.
Can I talk to you for a minute? I just got this in the mail from our man in L.A., Dr. Shindera, who got it from a Dr. Gottlieb. I think you ought to look at it right away. Jim, looks like there's a very weird epidemic breaking out among gay men in Los Angeles. There have been 5 cases of pneumocystis with no contributing disease within the past few months, and already 2 fatalities.
Hot stuff.
Mm-hmm. Plus, I made some phone calls to New York and San Francisco, and it seems that they've had similar cases. I think this ought to go into the weekly newsletter as soon as possible. What did you do that for?
I don't decide what goes in the newsletter. I can only recommend. But, Mary, we got a new administration. Do you want to see this published so that people can read it? Or do you want to see it killed?
Thanks. How long has it been?
Smallpox in India.
Come on, join us.
Dale, how long do you plan on doing that?
Till I get my peanut butter cookies.
Hey! Yeah!
Guys, I'd like you to meet Don Francis.
Hi, just doing a little demonstration of the benefits of a sound knowledge of applied science. Hi, Harold Jaffe, sexually transmitted diseases.
Oh. Hi, Don. Bill Darrow, sociology. You didn't shake Harold's hand, did you?
Don, hi. Thanks for coming. Did you meet everybody?
Yeah.
How's Phoenix?
Warm.
Don't we have a meeting in my office at 3:00? What's everybody doing here?
Trying to have lunch in 4 minutes, like you.
If one of those is peanut butter cookies, that is mine.
Let's go.
Dale Lawrence, Division of Host Factors. I killed them.
Okay, what we've got in Los Angeles, San Francisco, and New York is a number of gay men who've been hit with a variety of opportunistic infections, and really, that's all we know. I've asked Don to join us because for the last 3 years, he's been tracking hepatitis B virus in gay men, and before that, worked on the Ebola fever epidemic in Africa.
Yeah, thanks for joining us. What we've got to do is hit the phones and spread out, contact the health departments and all the major metropolitan areas as usual, so they can do a hospital-to-hospital search for cases.
Basic shoe leather epidemiology.
That's it. We've got to talk to the patients, talk to the doctors who may have treated those patients, and friends, relatives. No question too stupid or too personal.
Sexual relationships, too.
Lifestyle stuff.
Household chemical cleaning diet.
Could be a bad batch of street drugs.
Pets.
Yeah, maybe they all get the same kind of kitty litter.
Don, I'm going to go to New York this afternoon and take a look at this disease. Can you come with me?
Sure.
If I knew these blotches would turn purple, I'd have bought some bags to match. Here, look at my book, When I Was Still Human. I was the best in the business. Ask anybody. Leave it to me to get some disease nobody ever heard of. Kaposi's sarcoma. Even my doctor had to look it up. Nothing to worry about, he said. Usually happens to Italian men in their 60s who continue to live a normal life till they die of something else. Do I look like an Italian man in my 60s? Now I do. 160. Why do they make things like this that nobody can ever solve?
Oh, excuse me. I'm sorry.
Hello?
Would you like me to come back?
Can I help you?
I'm from the CDC, the Centers for Disease Control. Are you one of the interviews that Dr. Friedman Keen set up for me?
I'm sorry, I'm just having a little spot looked at here.
Oh, Gaetan Dugas, Dr. Mary Guinan. If you have a few minutes, it'd be very helpful if you talk to Dr. Guinan.
Oh, I'm sorry, but I'm barely going to make my plane as it is. If I'm lucky, I'm a flight attendant.
Well, would you mind answering a few questions while you're getting dressed?
What kind of questions?
I assume from what Dr. Friedman Keen told me that you're gay.
Also homosexual.
And how long have you been having sex with men?
About 10 years, I guess.
10.
Openly.
And could you roughly approximate how many sexual encounters you have in 1 year?
In a year?
Mm-hmm.
You're serious?
Yes.
I don't know.
Roughly.
About, 250? Yeah, actually, now that I think of it, that would be a very conservative estimate.
And of these partners,
look,
how
I'm
many...
I'm sorry. I would love to chat forever about my sex life. And we could. If I don't leave this minute, I'm going to miss my plane.
Oh.
Maybe next time, huh?
Okay.
All right. Doctor, I'll call you next month.
Fine.
All right. I look okay?
Great.
Of course I do. Thank you.
Thank you.
Doctor.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Do you have any gay friends, Harold? Not too many, no. Two doctors I knew at medical school. I still stay in touch with them.
Are they a couple?
Yeah, actually, 15 years at least.
Kiko and I, Kiko's my lover, we've got a wide circle of friends, and most of them are in relationships, or want to be in a relationship.
So what are you saying?
Lots of men go to these bathhouses, but there are tens of thousands of gay men in this city, maybe a couple of 100,000. You know, they're just cops and waiters and teachers and lawyers and ditch diggers and athletes.
They'll talk a little louder. They can't hear you down the block.
I'm sorry, I don't mean to lecture. I just don't want you to come away from your tour of the bathhouses thinking that's how all gay men live.
Last night, we lost another one. In less than 3 weeks, this handsome young guy turns into the elephant man, which we found out was caused by some rare parasite that only sheep get. So I called a vet to ask what they do when sheep get it. They shoot them.
Good luck.
Thanks. Selma.
Hi, Bill. Hi, Selma Dritz, Department of Public Health. We're here to inspect the premises.
I'll see if I can find the boss.
Thanks.
Those two guys there, they're strangers?
Maybe. Probably.
They just met, and now they're going to go in the...
Right.
It's interesting.
Listen to me. Imagine yourself in a place like this. Only it's filled with women. I mean, really beautiful women. I mean, imagine one of those penthouse women. And she wants to go into that little room with you, and there's nothing between you but a little towel. Are you going to tell me that you wouldn't go into that little room, seriously consider dropping that little towel?
Possibly, yeah.
Yeah. I know men who would give up food for it.
Hi, Eddie.
Darling, how are you?
Good. Eddie Papazzano, Dr. Harold Jaffe from the Centers for Disease Control.
Hi.
So what's the problem?
Well, there may be some kind of an epidemic spreading in the gay community, and I'd like to just come in and have a look around.
I'm sorry, that's impossible. We have to protect the confidentiality of our clients.
I know, but Eddie, you know that I speak on behalf of the Gay Liberation Committee, the City Council, the State Assembly. I can tell you without fear of contradiction, you are regarded, second only to Abling, as a citizen who would fight to the death to preserve civil liberties. So let's cut the crap. It's 10 o'clock in the morning, for God's sake. Let us in.
Selma, only for you.
Thank you.
Thanks.
You're a real mensch, Eddie.
So how many men come here a night?
Hundreds. Every night of the week. Some bathhouses more than 1,000.
What's this?
Poppers. They're a quick, cheap high.
What are you doing here?
What are you doing here?
Oh, God, my wife's gonna kill me. Did you get the results on the amyl nitrate study?
Yeah. You can forget about poppers. We ran every test there is. The worst thing that happened was two mice started dancing with the rubber glove.
Go home.
So far, not one TV station's even mentioned it. Not one word in the straight press. Nothing. The number of patients that I'm treating for it is growing so fast that I don't even want to think about it. I don't know. I mean, is anything happening in Washington? These people even know it exists?
If they do, they don't discuss it.
When do you go back to D.C.?
Tomorrow.
Well, then that's the first thing we have to deal with. You just have to make people aware of it.
Well, how, Mark? The media all say the same thing. There's no story. One journalist said to me, the only people interested in reading about gay men dying are gay men and the ones that wish they'd all die.
Well, I'm late for a meeting. Good luck. We don't get money for research, and soon, a lot of it. God help everyone.
Okay, Mark. What is it?
Nothing.
Can't you tell me?
Look, you have things to do. And they're very important things, and I can't tell you not to do them. And I guess I'd hate you if you didn't do them. But I just wish that we could. All I want is a place where we. This isn't. I don't know what I want.
All right, what do we think? What do we know? What can we prove?
Zip.
Only gays?
Think, but can't prove.
Only males?
Think, but can't prove.
Semen depositors. If it's in the semen, unless there's something specifically unusual about this disease, it shouldn't make a difference where the semen is deposited, whether in the anus or in the vagina, which could mean that women will be getting it also.
That's a good point. You should focus on that.
Well, all we know so far is that the immune system stops functioning completely.
In all cases?
No, but can't prove.
You know, what we have here looks more like a sexually transmitted disease than syphilis does.
Think or prove?
I can't prove that the sun isn't going to turn into a bran muffin next Tuesday. After 20 years of doing this, I know what I know.
That's not what I'm talking about.
Don't say it. I know it's pure supposition, but it's more than strong enough to justify a definitive study.
I agree with Bill. Yeah. It's a single infectious agent with a high probability of sexual transmission.
Well, then viral or bacterial?
Well, if you skip think and prove, I'd say viral, but it's only a guess.
A guess, definitely.
Okay, well, let's assume that it is a virus. Now, the question is it one that we already know that has become lethal, or is it some kind of brand new virus that we've never even seen before?
Here's a little stat to chew on. In 7 months, the number of cases jumped from 5 to 152 in 15 states.
7 months?
Yeah, but the spooky part is that so far, the mortality rate has been
40%. 40%?
And according to the doctors taking care of these patients, the mortality rate could ultimately turn out to be 100%.
100%.
My God.
All right, let's set up a case control study based on the premise that it's sexually transmitted. Don, I've been talking to the director. We want you to set up a lab here, run it, to handle the causative end of the study. If it's a bug, find it. I've just been given approval to head a task force for 3 months, which, if this disease is like any of the others, ought to be, you know, plenty of time. And of course, no money, so we're going to have to moonlight this epidemic.
What else is new?
That means I can't guarantee you with staff or equipment.
Trust him on this.
Until I juggle the budget around a little bit.
Okay. So you're going to show him where the lab's going to be?
Do you want to see it right now, do you think?
Oh, I think you should, Jim.
Yeah,
I
do.
Sure, come on down.
You got a flashlight, by the way?
It's not that bad.
You know, one of those minor things with a little light in it? You know,
it's the only space we have left, so it's going to look a little hopeless.
Only because it is.
No comment. It's actually, it's bigger than it looks. Tom Spira, Paul Fiorino, Don Francis.
Oh, nice to meet you.
Hi, Don.
What is this, incubator from the Smithsonian?
You know it too,
Where's the CO2 attachment?
Well, we had to put the CO2 tanks in the next room because we couldn't get approval for a real CO2 incubator.
Hopeless I can live with, but this is ridiculous.
Hey, watch it.
Stick around here. I might be coming right back.
Dr. Mary Guinan, please.
Your name? I'm a friend of Dr. Conant.
Your name?
You can tell him. He has no idea who you are, and we'll pretend we never heard of you.
You guys ahead of me?
You can go ahead. We've got nothing to do except go to a Halloween party. During rehearsal. I know. It's Trey Gauche Stefan, but I happen to think you're a genius. I mean, a double genius as a director and a choreographer.
To you?
Bobby Campbell, self-appointed KS poster boy. You look surprised.
No, I'm curious, maybe.
Well, you know, if the gay community doesn't start raising hell, do you think Reagan's gonna do a damn thing?
I wish I had your courage.
Courage? No. I'm scared to death. I just have this absurd determination to live. Don't you?
It's open.
Dr. Guinan?
Yes.
I tell you, I expected the neighborhood, the hotel, this room even. But I think it would take Fellini to cast such a beautiful young woman in a sweatsuit. As the doctor, I'm supposed to reveal my most intimate sexual eccentricities to.
Hello.
Hi.
I'm Mary Guinan, and the reason for the sweatsuit is somebody stole every piece of clothing I brought with me from the laundromat this morning. Would you mind signing these two consent forms? One is for the questionnaire, and one is for the specimens I need to collect.
Which specimens?
Blood, urine, a swab from the inside of your mouth, and another from your rectum. In this study, some have the disease, and some, like you, have no symptoms.
Hmm. You know, I really don't mind if you know all this about me. I'm just not too sure that I want to know. Is there a name yet for this disease?
The gay press calls it gay pneumonia, or gay cancer, and straight press doesn't mention it at all.
You know, I was hung up in traffic coming over here. The gay Halloween parade was on. Have you seen it?
I didn't know they had one.
Yeah, they do. It's really pretty amazing.
Sorry. What is that?
It's today's figures.
No. Butchers.
In the war against Napoleon, when Admiral Nelson wanted to know how many people were dead, he'd yell to his orderly, "What's the butcher's bill for today?"
Oh, God.
We've injected Mary's samples into mice and rabbits and guinea pigs, and we're going to try monkeys. So far, we haven't found any evidence of parasites, fungus, or viruses. It's nothing.
You mean the case control study yielded zilch?
Yeah. All we know so far is that the disease is caused by some unknown organism or organisms which we can't see or find. We don't know if it's a single agent or a combination of causes. We don't know how it's transmitted. We don't know... Don't touch that! Christ. Don't you know there's about a million things in there that could kill you? I'm sorry.
Ces deux femmes, par exemple. Toutes les deux africaines. Toutes les deux meurent de pneumocystis. Ce qui est ridicule, personne ne meurt de pneumocystis. Pourtant, 19 personnes en sont mortes en 3 ans. Des riches, des pauvres, des femmes, des hommes, des Français, des Africains. On peut voir cette maladie chez les homosexuels en France et aux États-Unis. Ok. Je vous retrouve tout de suite.
Bonjour. C'est comment lui,
bonjour. S'il vous plaît, Dr. Rosenbaum, asseyez-vous. C'est très embarrassant pour moi. Nous sommes tous les deux des hommes de cœur. Mais on dit de nous, cet hôpital, où vont ces gens-là?
Vous savez, je ne fais aucune publicité. Les médecins m'envoient leurs malades. Peut-être parce que j'étais le premier à en parler.
Bon nombre de nos patients normaux refusent de venir ici. Ils ont peur. Cela peut mettre notre hôpital dans une situation extrêmement inconfortable. Vous comprenez ce que je dis? Puis-je considérer que c'est la fin de cette affaire?
Non, c'est la fin de la discussion. La fin de cette affaire, c'est que je vais chercher un autre hôpital.
Politically, as far as the next election is concerned, we're not dead, but we're in a coma.
For 20 years, I built that coalition. So solid, nobody could touch me.
The only group you can count on to vote as a solid bloc, because it's literally life and death for them now, is the gay vote. And San Francisco is probably the only city in the world where that group is big enough to swing the election. Without them, you're the ex-godfather of San Francisco.
What do they want?
Disability insurance for grid, if they get it, for one thing. Gay-related immune deficiency. And money for research, that is crucial. Nobody knows what's causing this thing.
I'll introduce a bill. But if all the angels came dancing down to Earth like the Rockettes, even they couldn't get a dime out of this administration for anything with the name gay on it.
In New York today, President Reagan asked voters in Little Italy to support his economic recovery program.
I've never seen so many calories lined up. We have to turn the direction around that we've been going in order to end inflation, end unemployment, and get this country back where it should be in the eyes of the world.
But at year's end, it appears that there will be less money to spend for public health next year.
I'm sure there's one department you've been waiting for me to mention, the Department of Defense. It's the only department in our entire program that will actually be increased over the present budgeted figure.
I don't suppose you heard back on the requisition I put in for an electron microscope.
Well, how can I put this to you diplomatically?
Not approved.
Not approved.
I don't know how I'm supposed to run this lab without the basic fundamental. Every month I write a memo asking, where's the $196,000 I need to run this lab? I can't even get a simple yes or no.
I am tired. I'm going to go home. I'm going to go to bed. And really, I suggest you do the same thing, all right?
Not approved.
Dr. Kern.
Yeah, what is it?
Jeff called. There's been an outbreak among the Haitian population in Miami.
How many?
4 known dead. But they said that since most of them are hiding from immigration, there could be dozens more. None of them are gay, he said. Just Haitians.
What do you mean, just Haitians?
That's what he said to ask you.
Yeah, okay, thanks. Boy, just Haitians. I don't know. This disease does not make any sense to me. I don't get it. It's completely off the wall. You know, a doctor in the Bronx has just announced that 11 newborn babies have got it. And now, Haitians. It's not just a gay disease anymore.
The National Center for Disease Control is reporting more cases of 2 rare and deadly diseases found in homosexual men. There is no apparent explanation for the outbreak, but health officials are urgently looking for an answer.
It appeared a year ago in New York's gay community, then in the gay communities of San Francisco and Los Angeles. Now it's been detected in Haitian refugees. No one knows why. Specialists argue that millions of dollars should be spent for research now.
Bobby Campbell is fighting for his life, one of a rapidly growing group whose battle has fascinated and frightened modern medicine. He has Kaposi sarcoma, a deadly skin cancer that first appeared on the bottom of his feet as spots the size of a quarter.
When I first came down with the disease, I found this button, which absolutely reflected my position at the time. I may be down, but I'm not out.
Gay plague is sweeping across our country. Say, God is not mocked. You can't fool God. You break all of his laws, and God Almighty will judge you.
Hey, Don. Hey, Dave.
Hey, Dr. Kathy.
Listen, can I get, like, a really big chunk of meatloaf with gravy and a couple of pickles?
Absolutely.
Thanks.
Hello.
Matter. What do we think? What do we know? What can we prove? I'm so sick of that. I mean, the only thing we know for sure is that we don't know anything, which also happens to be the only thing we can prove. We think. Or do we know? Or do we think we know? I don't know what the hell it is.
It's a jelly donut.
Oh, well, thanks, Harold. It's a jelly donut.
You're very welcome.
I owe you about a quarter. Gobbling up the T cells. I'm telling you, Max, feline leukemia might be a clue. Really looks infectious to me, just like your favorite bug, the feline leukemia virus. Look, they both cause cancer, right?
Okay.
They both cause immune suppression. Something's gobbling up those T cells.
Okay.
They both have long incubation periods.
Suspect or no?
But these guys have had swollen lymph nodes, fevers, all sorts of things for years before they get Kaposi sarcoma.
Good. It's hardly scientific proof, but it's good.
All right. What's that hepatitis B? Causes cancer, right?
Right.
Immune suppression, no. Has a long incubation period. Can take up to 30 years to give cancer to the liver.
Right.
Transmitted by sex. No? Yes. It all fits. It fits. The disease that we're looking for looks like a combination between feline leukemia and hepatitis B. So isn't it likely, Max, what we're looking for is some kind of new virus, like the retrovirus that causes feline leukemia?
Possible. It's also possible that since your two fields of expertise are feline leukemia and hepatitis B, what looks like a scientific eureka might only be a case of wishful thinking.
It's possible. Maybe likely.
Actually, it could be a retrovirus, in which case we need Bob Gallo.
Will we have to kiss his ring?
Probably.
But here's a man who became world famous for having found the first human retrovirus, HTLV. But he still hasn't found a major illness to link it to. And if this turns out to be the one...
Then Bob Gallo gets the Nobel Prize.
Sorry, Dr. Gallo.
You sorry about winning? I'll never be sorry about winning. When you don't get your promotion next month, that's when you should be sorry.
Dr. Gallo.
Yeah?
Telephone.
Gallo here.
Bob, Max Essex.
Max, how are you?
Are you working on that new gay disease yet?
No, I'll tell you the truth, Max. It really doesn't interest me.
Well, Don Francis used to be my student. He's with the CDC now. And he's found enough evidence to suggest that it might be caused by some retrovirus, possibly in the same family as yours. Now, I'm going to explore this with him, and I think it's something you ought to look into.
Well, why don't you send me what you have, and I'll put somebody on it.
Excellent.
Thanks for the call, Max. Bye.
What did it say? We got it.
It's not a problem, I read.
Jim, I got a call from L.A.
Wait a minute, I'm on the phone. I can get you this.
I got a call from L.A. This could be the first real lead to prove this thing is sexually transmitted. My plane leaves in 40 minutes.
Hold on. We don't have the budget yet.
No, don't sweat it. I'll front the money. Yeah. You'll pay me back.
Okay, well, if you think you have definitive proof it was brought in by a UFO, please send it in to us. Thank you.
Six, six, six.
Excuse me?
That is my room number. See, that's when I called the public health department. When I saw what room they put me in. And nobody listened to me. Nobody listens in this place!
I'll listen to you. That's why I'm here.
It all started with a barbecue. It was in the summer of 1980. We had it in our backyard, and it was just me and my lover and a gay couple from up the street. Now, one of them died on October 6th, 1981. And one died on February 6th, 1982. And the other one died on March 6th, 1982. There are three sixes, you see?
Yes. Yes, now all of them died of this new disease.
They're three sixes. They're three sixes, so I...
Do you see any of the names of those men on this list?
October 6th. It's 81. February 6th. It's 82. And March 6th. 82. Well, thank you.
Good. Now, you had sex with all three of these men?
Can you hear that?
What?
Do you hear that? Dun, 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 dun. The music. Dun. It's playing upside down. Which instead of backwards means... Oh, I'm number four on the list. I'm number four. And two makes... Would you tell me the absolute truth? Would you, no matter how terrifying that may be?
I'll try to.
Does it make a difference if I was cremated?
I don't understand. I'm sorry.
Him, and him, and I miss him very much.
I am 32 years old, and I'm dying. Can't you just leave me alone?
I'm sorry.
Get him out of here!
Here's my card.
God damn it, Blaine! Get him out of here!
Sorry to bother you.
Mr. Darrow. I'm not his lover. I'm just a friend who takes care of him on Thursdays. We take turns in a buddy program. I'm not sure if this is what you're looking for, but I think Greg got it from a man from New York.
You don't know a man from New York with a French-Canadian accent, do you? Very handsome, I was told, very chic.
No, I don't think so. I mean, I very seldom... Wait a minute. This might help somebody else, right?
Right.
Of course I know him. From the bathhouses. I never had sex with him, but almost everybody I know has or wants to.
So fun. Then again, he gave me hepatitis, so it's quite possible to give me this, too. From the moment I first spied him at the Tubbs, I was so crazy about him. He was so gorgeous.
Can you just give me his phone number or address or any way I can get a hold of him?
All I know is he's French-Canadian, he's an airline steward based in New York. I don't even know which airline.
No, that's okay. You can just give me his name.
We called him Dougie. Nickname.
Dougie. And his full name. Hi, Mary.
Hi. You back in town?
Just for the night. I'm probably nuts, but I'm on my way to New York to try and find a very sexually active French-Canadian airline steward.
Gaetan Dugas, Bill Darrow.
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Sit down. Take all the time you need.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks very much for coming in.
Ah, well, I'm very flattered to be asked. Although I have no idea what I'm here to discuss. I wouldn't disturb you if I smoke.
If you need to, go ahead. Mr. Dugas. Have you had sex with any of these people?
Is that what I'm here for? To talk about my beautiful lovers? And now I am flattered. Although, if you don't mind my saying, I cannot possibly imagine why you'd be interested.
You've been finding substantial evidence to suggest that one of the ways this disease may be transmitted is sexually.
Now, wait a minute. Look, all I have is skin cancer, which is not contagious, and you know it.
No one's accusing you of anything. We just need to know as much as we can.
You know, I adore doctors, but I must say, if it is an epidemic, this gay plague thing, it's your fault for not stopping it. It's not mine.
That's exactly what we're trying to do. And we need everybody's help. So if you could give me the names and addresses of all your lovers and start with the people on this list, please.
My friend, we're talking about thousands of men all over the world whose faces I cannot even remember, and you want names.
Well, as many as you can remember would help.
My book's in my apartment. You call me, huh?
What's the number?
I'll call you.
Listen, help me, don't help me. That's up to you. But don't fuck with me. I'm not playing games here.
Not before 6, and not after 6:30.
Thank you.
And remember something. Whatever it is, if I've got it, someone gave it to me.
All right.
unfair.
Mine.
Whoa, 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 this is important.
Well, not to me.
Yes.
Oh,
hello. It's Bill Darrow from the CDC.
You have plenty of paper? I got 73 names.
70? Sure. Yeah. Uh-huh. All right, this is how it breaks down. This is patient zero, an airline steward from New York, and the starting point of this particular group. Now, these are the eight with whom he had direct sexual contact. These four in New York, these four in L.A. This is LA3. He had sex with LA2, this man from Florida, who in turn had sex with this Florida man, two from Georgia, one from Texas, and so on. In all, 40 cases in 10 cities are verifiably linked to patient zero, which strongly suggests this is a sexually transmitted disease.
That's great. That's absolutely terrific work, Bill. That's great.
Bill, that is the first sign of real proof.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Good job.
Is there any indication why patient zero is still alive and others in this cluster died almost immediately?
Well, we just have to assume a variable incubation period.
Yeah.
How many of these connections were made in bathhouses?
Most of them.
Most of them. You know what we have to do? We have to close the bathhouses.
The federal government doesn't have authority to do that. How soon before you can write up a full report?
4 or 5 days.
Listen, Jim, I'm from the Bay Area. I could just go up and...
Don, could you stay out of this, please? It's not my decision what to do with this information, and it's certainly not yours. Something this important has to go upstairs first, and based on what they recommend, we can act.
Are you saying that the public might not even be told what we just found out?
Are you saying this is or is not a sexually transmittable disease?
The existence of a cluster study provides evidence for an hypothesis that people in the study are not randomly associated with each other, and the study is a sexual cluster. On the other hand, we don't have enough scientific evidence to say for certain that one person gives it to another person. We have to focus much more research into this area so that we don't prematurely release information that's not validated. On the other hand, we're not holding back any information that might provide important health benefits. Thank you.
In a situation that might cause the White House a little embarrassment, your idea is just to roll over and play dead.
Albert, what is this? I am the bureaucratic whore. You're Lawrence of Arabia. You think I like doing everything that I have to do?
I don't know. Do you?
Look, one of my jobs is to make sure that I don't start a nationwide panic, all right?
Is that worse than a nationwide epidemic?
I am not going to make enemies of the people who can cut off what little funding that we have left. Don, I'm juggling a dozen balls here, political,
what about science and medicine?
What I said in there was pure science, and you know it. Now, there is strong evidence, but there's nothing that we can prove scientifically. And without
you know,
that,
it could take up to 5 years to establish scientific proof. How many people are going to get sick in that time?
Okay, fine. Let's just say that we get rid of the idea of scientific proof. What are you going to replace it with? The Ouija board school of epidemiology?
When a house is on fire, you don't wait for scientific proof. You grab the first hose and you start putting out the fire. I am just talking about a modern. Hold on. Just wait a second. If somebody has. Somebody has.
God damn it, just shut the hell up! God, I can't believe it. Every time we have a meeting in this town, we don't end in a brawl, we start with one.
In the first place, I don't have the power to shut down the bathhouses.
Oh, Merv, as Director of Public Health, you have the power to shut down anything that threatens public health.
According to the CDC press conference, there's no compelling evidence that it's sexually transmitted.
Oh, damn well. If this epidemic was killing grandmothers and virgins, you'd have an army of investigators out there.
Thank you. Exactly. This is San Francisco, where bathhouse is not just a word, it is a symbol for sexual freedom.
Thank you.
I'm sorry. If you want these bathhouses closed down, the gay community is going to have to help close them. Good night.
That's it.
No way he's going to budge and commit political suicide. And why should he, with the gay community split right down the middle?
Oh, Selma, we are not split down the middle. The vast majority of gay men are in stable monogamous relations.
The vast majority of it.
They don't go to the bathhouses. It's only the minority. Okay, a vocal minority.
If something isn't done about this epidemic, they're dead. The vocal minority and a lot more besides.
Just wait a second.
Kiko? What's the matter?
There's been a... For a while now...
You don't have to tell me.
Yes, I do. I met someone. He's an architect. Something awful if you stopped being my friend.
How can I stop being your friend?
Five, six, seven, eight.
Really happy you could come.
Well, thank you for asking.
Well, you said you're gonna be in New York. I'm sorry I couldn't be more specific with you on the phone. I think I got this thing. I'm really scared. Why am I so afraid to tell anybody about this? You know, I know how hard it is for you people to get the kind of money you need to fight this thing, so... You just use that wherever you think it'll do the most good, all right?
Thank you.
Get out of here. I gotta get back to work.
Trouble with the CDC, couldn't it?
Probably.
As I try to say on the phone, the CDC caused chaos here.
That press conference was so ambiguous about sexual transmission, the gay community is in complete turmoil. Excuse me.
How much longer do you think we're going to wait here?
Let me tell you people something. No matter what happens here today, if you try to close my joint, I'll sue the ass off.
Doesn't it bother you knowing that the people who have sex in your bathhouse are playing Russian roulette?
Please, just cut out this bullshit. We're all in this for one thing, money. I make it when the guys come in, you doctors, you make it when they go out.
How long are we gonna wait for? He's almost an hour late. Let's go.
Can we settle down, please? Please, everybody settle down so we can start. Thank you, please. So while we're waiting for Dr. Silverman, your director of public health, I've got some good news to report. Not just here in San Francisco, but right across the country, gay organizations are raising money to fight this epidemic.
I'd like to introduce now Dr. Don Francis from the Centers for Disease Control in Atlanta, who's been fighting this epidemic from the start. Don?
First of all, let me tell you that I'm not speaking on behalf of the Centers for Disease Control. I'm speaking for myself. There may have been some confusion caused by the way the information was distributed about whether or not this disease is sexually transmittable. I'm here to give you the absolute truth about what we've found. First, if you get this disease, the chances are about 100% that you're going to die. Second, one of the ways that you can get this disease is by having sex with somebody who already has it. We have established that most of the people who have this disease got it in a bathhouse. How can you say we get it from sex when the CDC just said we don't get it from sex?
Yeah! This is another Reagan trick to shove us back in the closet. Yeah!
What about the bathhouses? Yeah!
Okay, the man we've all been waiting for, your director of health, Dr. Mervyn Silverman.
The reason for this meeting is to discuss how we feel. Who would like to...
Hold the top.
Bobby Campbell. Bobby Campbell, go ahead. Would you like to say something?
Now, for years and years and years, people in my hometown were telling me I was a freak because of my sexual orientation. Until I came to San Francisco. And I found a community of freaks just like me. And we stood together. We stood together. And it took a long time. But we finally forced this one tiny spot of the universe, the Castro, to realize that how we choose to have sex and where is our own damn business. Yeah! Which I know the people who haven't gone through what we've gone through sounds funny, and they may laugh. But I know, speaking for most of us, I would rather die as a human being than continue living as a freak. Boy, there's a lot of strong feeling on this subject.
What good is all the gay rights in the world if we're all dead?
Before I make my decision, I'd just like to put this to a vote. All those who are in favor of the city closing the bathhouses, raise your hand.
Close the top. Save lives.
All those who are in favor of keeping the bathhouses open, raise your hands.
I don't understand.
They're human, Bill. And they're scared.
aussi, docteur.
C'est un peu, c'est évident. Infirmière.
Docteur.
Story.
Voilà. Normal.
Attention.
Désolé du retard, mais on était coincé rue de Rennes.
Il faut espérer que les ganglions détiennent le secret de la maladie. On va mettre celui-ci en réserve.
Je suis fasciné de voir combien les Américains peuvent penser qu'une maladie puisse avoir des préférences sexuelles. Ils pensent que ça, les Américains. Sexe, sexe, sexe.
Within weeks and quickly. Just have Gallo report the detection of his virus, HTLV, and what?
It was the two East Coast homosexuals, Robin.
Two East Coast homosexuals. All right, send this out right away, now, to science. This is big. This is big. We finally got the big one. Mika, tell all our number one people to drop whatever they're doing, get to work on this. From this day, March what?
3rd.
Dr. Robert Gallo makes the first gigantic strides in winning the, what, the war, the battle?
The war?
Battle. Against whatever the hell they call it now.
Françoise, à toi l'honneur. Le chiffre atteint 20 000, nous n'avons pas de retrovirus.
Merde, c'est juste un bruit de fond. Où avons-nous fait l'erreur?
On recommence à zéro. Il faut modifier mes lieux de culture, vérifier les étiquettes, voir s'il n'y a pas eu d'erreur en cours d'expérimentation.
They're calling it. He died after another, quote, long illness. So sad.
This could be the first deadly epidemic in history of which nobody officially died.
Yeah.
Hey, look at this. Did you see this? Look at this article.
What?
In order to move quickly and take the lead in what seems likely to be a fierce scientific battle against grid, Dr. Robert Gallo has formed a special unit of the National Cancer Institute to fight and win the battle against this disease by the end of the year.
What?
Hey, hot damn, we're in business.
Don, I'm an IV drug user in New York. I just got back, died from it.
Gay?
A woman.
It's in the blood supply.
How long has he been ill?
He was born with it.
No, no, I don't mean hemophilia. He was doing fine until, well, recently, wasn't he?
Well, he's crippled in one knee because they couldn't stop the bleeding until a few years ago when they came out with that new stuff.
Factor VIII.
Now look at him. He was doing fine just a few weeks ago.
Did you happen to get a new supply of Factor VIII about that same time?
What is that exactly? Fake blood or something?
No. It's real blood, but they get it from thousands of different people and put it through a lot of different filters and take out things and add things to it till all they got is the clotting stuff that makes you, well, stop bleeding.
He was doing fine until a few weeks ago.
I'm really sorry about this, but I've got some questions which are, well, embarrassing, but I've got to ask them. Has he ever had sexual contact with another man?
I don't understand the question. I mean, he's a man. How can a man have sex with another man?